Hi, I'm Chase Sharkey with Sharkey Mechanical. Our team of experts handle some of the largest and most complex air conditioning systems in the state. Give us a call today and let us attack your air conditioning needs. 225-222-3332.
Well, he's back on the campaign trail, Luke Letlow, running for Congress, although you're no stranger to the office of Dr. Ralph Abraham, our incumbent congressman, who's not running for re-election this year.
No, that's right. I'm down in Tangipahoa today. I'll be in Washington Parish tomorrow. Feel like I'm right at home. I've been here a lot, and I'll continue to be here through this campaign.
So here we are at the Cafe in Kentwood, which is an iconic location on the north end, and you've had breakfast with some locals. What did you hear?
Well, I heard a lot about how this community is coming together, dealing with COVID, certainly they're proud of this community. They're proud to come together. I learned a lot about, what community is down here, and I love that it's part of the 5th District. I want to represent it in Congress.
So can we just back up a second and explain this crazy 5th District, because it goes literally from the Mississippi state line down to almost New Orleans.
That's exactly right. It goes from, I say it often, Bastrop to Bunky to Bogalusa. Opelousas is included, 24 parishes. If you're looking at a map, yes, it is a lot of miles in between A to B. But I know it well. I've served as the Chief of Staff to Congressman Abraham. I love these parishes. They actually have a lot in common, rural communities whether it's logging, it's timber, it's dairy. I'm going to seek to be on the Ag Committee. I want to represent these communities here, just like those communities where I grew up.
Well, one of the concerns when you have a congressman from far away is, will they be accessible? Will they be available? Will there be constituent service? It's incredible how many times a congressional office can be of assistance to people.
You're exactly right. One of the most important things I think that a congressman does that often is forgotten is constituent services. You know, whether it's a veteran who hasn't gotten benefits that are rightly theirs, whether it's the IRS who has made an error. Believe it or not, the government makes errors every single day. That's my job as your next congressman, to make sure that the government treats you fairly. I will commit to making sure that we have an office in the Florida parishes. Right now we've got one in Monroe, one in Alexandria. There is one in West Feliciana. Whether it's there or somewhere closer to the middle, we will absolutely have a presence here in the Florida parishes.
Are you picking up on any local issues here in the Florida parishes?
I have talked a lot to some of the dairy farmers. I know they've got a challenge that the dairy community has had for generations. It's gotten harder and harder. A lot of rural development issues. One of the main things I've got to focus on as your next congressman is rural broadband. We have got to have rural broadband. It's got to be a federal expense and investment, just like Eisenhower invested in the interstates in the 1950s.
You know, it's amazing, and especially how spotty it can be.
It can be. Look, I grew up in a place called Start, Louisiana, home of Tim McGraw. I don't have rural broadband myself, so I empathize. I understand if you're trying to get rural telemedicine, if you're trying to get your kids to be logged into the school to do tele-education, you can't do it without high-speed rural broadband. We've got to make sure our communities are connected to the world.
So in the Whatever Happened To department, how about the Zachary Taylor Parkway, which would turn Sleepy Highway 10 into a super highway? They said it would never happen because we'd never afford the bridge, but now
the bridge is there. That's right. Look, I think we've got to make sure we get our fair share of our dollars back from Washington. We pay, we pay in. We certainly need to get our money back to make sure that we're building infrastructure. We know that if you build the infrastructure, jobs can come, economies will grow. It's something we should be investing in. I know what the Zachary Taylor Parkway is, and I'll support that investment.
So, if the polls are right and we get a Democratic president, that means that in 2 years, the Republicans will come roaring back, and it would actually be likely that you would no longer be a freshman in Congress, but rather part of the majority party.
You're right. I think it's going to be a challenge for Republicans to win the House as a whole in this term. We don't know what the White House will turn into, whether it's Donald Trump or Joe Biden, but you're right. I'm going to Washington for the long haul. I want to make sure that we get the leadership, just like Congressman Scalise has done in the 1st District. I know him well. I've spoken to him in the last 2 weeks. I want to go there to build the seniority needed to help our people. And I think I can do it quickly. He set the bar on how to do that.
Well, you basically ran the congressional office for Dr. Abraham, and you're well known in this area because you came with him so many different places. You're almost an incumbent in the race.
Well, look, I don't take anything for granted. I'm talking to every voter where there are two or more people gathered. It's hard with COVID. But I'm here today. I'm going to be talking to people throughout the day. I'm all over this district every single day. The reality is I'm the only candidate in this race who's got the qualifications to represent our people on day one. And, you know, with COVID, with hurricanes that have impacted our communities, we don't have time for somebody to learn how to do this job. That's why I want to be your congressman.
So I've lost track of how many candidates are in this race with you, but it's a bunch.
There's 9 candidates total. I take them all seriously. I don't really think that there's not many candidates from this end of the district. I intend to win this district because I want the votes here more than anyone else does. I've got the fire in the belly, and I'm gonna earn every single vote.
But with 9 candidates, doesn't that mean a runoff is almost inevitable?
I think you're absolutely right. There will inevitably be a runoff.
That'll be in December.
It'll be in December, that's right. It'll be a day before my 41st birthday. You know, I'm no longer a young man. I've spent time in this district learning the issues, learning the people, their concerns. I'm excited to go to Washington to work for our people, to get some jobs into these communities. There's a lot I can do as your congressman to do that.
But between COVID, the economy, the Trump election, and so forth, I mean, how do you get people to care and even turn out in December for a congressional race?
Well, you know, I think that it's part of my job to make sure people care. I will be on the airwaves. I'll be reminding people that we have an election in December. You know, Senator Cassidy has, 13, 14 opponents himself. He may be in a runoff as well. Look, concerned citizens in Louisiana, we know when the elections occur. Our citizens are not known for not voting. We have a very active populace. In fact, we've got a higher voter turnout than we do a census participation rate. So I'm excited about getting people enthused and energetic about my campaign because I want to help this district.
What else do you want to share with us?
Look, go to visit my website, LukeLetlow.com. Proud to be endorsed by Congressman Ralph Abraham. Proud to be endorsed by Garrett Graves. But the most important endorsement I want is yours.
Amwaste is the only full-service garbage disposal company in Tangipahoa Parish, offering from residential pickup to commercial pickup to construction, as well as heavy industrial disposal. At Amwaste, we pride ourselves in great service and competitive pricing. So let Amwaste be your waste provider, because at Amwaste, we care about our customers. Call today.